before you, because you are the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Oh Lord, there's no one like you, Father. Oh, we lift you up as our great God, Father. Father, come and visit us, Holy Spirit. Be part of this service today, in Jesus' name, Father. Father, even let your angels come and sit amongst us, Father, as we worship you, Father. Bible says, Father, that the angels will sing, holy, holy, holy are you, Lord, because you are holy, Father. And Lord, we enter, Father, into your kingdom, Father. We want to enter into your kingdom, Father, because it's all about your kingdom. Let your kingdom come. Let your will be done today as we worship you here today, Father. We want the visitation in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Say hi. Hallelujah. It's good to be now. just lift up your hands and just focus on God. Don't look at the chairs or where we are at. We just need to worship you. Amen.
To worship you, I live. think the Lord has guided me to speak on the topic of offering is my part of worship. God wants us to see our money as something holy and something which we offer in worship to Him. And that without this offering, our worship is incomplete. In the book of Exodus, we see God gave regulations for every male in Israel to come to Jerusalem 3 times a year. They were to offer worship and to celebrate before God. And I'll start reading from verse 14. Three times you shall keep a fast to me in the year. You shall keep the feast of unleavened bread. You shall eat unleavened bread 7 days, for I commanded you, at the time appointed in the month of Abib. For in it you came out of Egypt. None shall appear before me empty. And the first of the feast of harvest, and the first fruit of your labors, which you have sown in the field, and the feast of ingathering, at the end of the year, when you have gathered in the fruit of your labors from the field, 3 times in a year, all your males shall appear before the Lord God. You shall not offer the blood of my sacrifice with leavened bread, nor shall the fat of my sacrifice remain until the morning. The first of your fruits, the first of the fruits of your land, you shall bring into the house of the Lord your God. You shall not boil a young goat in its mother's milk. Yeah, Israel had to come up to God, come up at God's appointed time and in God's appointed way. No Israelite was to appear before God empty-handed. Every Israelite had to have an offering for God as part of celebration and worship. We too must follow this example. When we present ourselves at God's house for worship, we must present ourselves with an offering which is part of our worship and in accordance with the word of God. Church, may we all rise this morning as we get ready to give our tithes and offering as part of our worship to God. As we do so, I would like say this confession of faith after me.
God is with us. If we just call upon His name and we keep Him in our hearts, He's everywhere. He's there. Amen. So this morning, He's also with us. Amen. Amen. Let's just bow our heads. Father God, we invite You in this place, Almighty God. Father, we pray that You may take a seat, Almighty God, in this place, Almighty God. May You speak, O Father God, and may we listen, O Father God. Lord, we pray for our hearts, O God, and our ears, O mighty God. Let it not be like stone, O mighty God, but let us be willing to hear Your word this morning, O God. It is You who's speaking, O Father God. Lord, we thank You for this opportunity, O God, another opportunity, O mighty God, to gather in Your presence, O Father God, with Your people, O mighty God, to praise Your name, O Father God, to give You glory, to give You worship, O mighty God. Father God, we thank You, O God. Your presence, O God, is so beautiful, Almighty God. It's so awesome, Almighty God. It's so good to be in Your house, Almighty God. Father God, our portion is joy, Almighty God. Our portion is healing, Almighty God. Father God, we thank You, Almighty God, for who You are, Almighty God. It's not by our works, Almighty God, that You have saved us, Almighty God. But You have saved us, Almighty God, irrespective of our sins, Almighty God. You have washed us, Almighty God. Lord God, we thank You for what You do in our lives daily, Almighty God, and what You are continuing to do, O Father God. Lord, we have our hope, Almighty God, and it is in You, Almighty God. Our hope in You, O Father God, will never change, Almighty God. We thank You for being such a faithful God, Almighty God. There's nothing that can shake You, Almighty God. You are the same God, O God, yesterday, today, and forevermore, Almighty God. You are with us, O Father God. And we pray, Almighty God. Lord, we pray for our pastor, Almighty God. We bring his healing, O Father God, in Your name, Almighty God. Father God, healing is his portion, Almighty God, because he is Your son, O Father God. And You will do a miracle, Almighty God. He is in Your hands, Almighty God. But Father God, we will praise You nonetheless, Almighty God. We will worship You today, O Father God, for who You are, Almighty God. Lord God, take Your seat in the service, Almighty God. Let our hearts listen to Your word today, Almighty God. We thank You, O Jesus, in Your wonderful name.
Hebrews 6 verse 19 says,
We have this hope as an anchor for the soul that firms us and secures us. And this hope is Jesus, amen? He is our anchor. Why is he our anchor? Why can we rely on him? Because he is unchangeable and he is unshakable. He is someone that we can rely on, amen? Can we open our Bibles to Matthew? Matthew 7. Jesus was sleeping. The disciples went and woke him, saying, "Lord, save us. We are going to drown." He replied, "You of little faith, why are you so afraid?" Then he got up and rebuked the winds and the waves, and it was completely calm. Amen? So we see through the storms and the waves, the disciples were afraid. They were afraid of drowning, of being tossed around. Amen? And we see that immediately the disciples, they acknowledge that Jesus is the only one who can calm the storms. They acknowledge this man can do something. They think, why is this man sleeping? Is he not afraid that we are going to drown? But they acknowledge that there's something in this man that can calm the storm. They acknowledge that he is the anchor, amen? Although many of these disciples, as we learn about the disciples, we learn how Jesus met these disciples. They were fishermen, amen? If we remember that. And although they have experience with the storms and the winds of the ocean, they could do nothing, amen, because it was not in their control. So they relied on Jesus to calm the storm. Verse 26 says, he replied, "You of little faith, why are you afraid?" And then he got up and he rebuked the winds and the waves, and it was completely calm, amen. How beautiful is that, to have someone that can rebuke our storms and waves, and it can be restored as being calm. Amen. Can we open in our Bibles to 1 Corinthians? Which is Jesus Christ. If anyone builds on this foundation using gold, silver, costly stones, wood, hay, or straw, their work will be shown for what it is, because the day will bring it to light. It will be revealed with fire, and the fire will test its quality. Amen. I'm just going to read that again. It says, for no one can lay any foundation other than the one that has already been laid. So Jesus Christ forms the foundation of the church and all of the believers. So verse 11 says again, for no one can lay a foundation on one that has already been built. So our foundation has already been built on Jesus Christ. Amen? So nothing and no one else will do. And then he goes on to say, if anyone builds on the foundation using gold, silver, wood, or hay. So this means if our foundation is on anything else but Jesus, if our foundation is, if it's on our wealth, if we tend to rely on our wealth, if our foundation is on people, it will not last. Amen? A home constructed with the finest materials will quickly crumble if it is resting on unstable ground. Any building is only as solid as its foundation. And our foundation is Jesus Christ. He is our base and He is our reason for living. Everything we are and we do must rest on the foundation of His life and His word. So today, are we building our life on the only real lasting foundation, or are we building our life on a faulty foundation that is wealth, that can be success, that can be human relationships? So we need to be careful what we build our foundation on. We need to be careful what our anchor is and who it is, because our foundation needs to be firm. Amen? So what makes Jesus a firm foundation? Why should we rely on Him? Why should we choose Him as our foundation? And why should we not choose wealth and success and relationships as our foundation? Because He is the same God. He's the same God that was yesterday. He's the same God who is today and who will be forevermore. Amen? He is not a man that can say something today and then tomorrow He can change His mind. He's not like the weather. Amen? So our seasons and circumstances can change, but the Lord does not change. Amen? Today we can be so wealthy and there can be a storm that comes in our lives and it just tosses us from any direction and we look to our wealth, but today, tomorrow it cannot be there. Amen? We can be in foot shape or healthy and then tomorrow we can, sickness can come upon us. Amen? And we rely just on our body being fit. Amen? But tomorrow it can all change. Amen? But Jesus Christ does not change. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. Can we open in our Bibles back to Matthew? I'm reading from chapter 7, verse 24. It says, therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain comes down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall, amen, because it had its foundation on the rock. And our rock he's talking about is Jesus Christ, amen. So if we continue to read this scripture, it was talking about two people that Jesus compares at the end of the Sermon on the Mountain. And they have several points in common. So they both are builders, and they both hear Jesus' teaching, and they both experience the same set of circumstances in life. So the difference between them isn't that they lack knowledge, but that one ignores Jesus' words. So externally, their lives may look similar, but their lasting structural differences will be revealed by the storms of their lives. So when we follow Jesus, the immediate difference between your life and the lives of others may not be obvious at first, but the benefits will eventually affect your eternal destiny. So today, are we wise builders practicing the powerful teachings and promises that Jesus gave us? So in this scripture, Jesus is talking about two people that one of them built their house on the rock and the other one built their house on straw. And obviously the one that built their house on straw is going to be stronger, amen? And it says in verse 25, the rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against the house. So this is talking about our circumstances in life. And it says, yet it did not fall because it had its rock on the foundation. So today we will not fall if our foundation is Christ. Amen. The winds can blow, but we will not fall because we have a stable foundation. Amen. So how do we stay anchored and how do we stay firm in God? So number one is by being familiar with His Word. Amen. Number two is by allowing God to speak to us. Amen. David says in his Psalms, your word is a lamp to my feet. So David is using the Lord's word as his direction. Amen. And what are we using as our direction this morning? Are we looking at our wealth? Are we looking at our success? Or are we trusting in God? Amen.
Amen.
And thirdly, by standing on His promises, rather than taking actions into our own hands, amen? So these are the days that our faith is really being tested, amen? We all can relate to this, amen? So we need to stand firm and be planted in God, amen? So this morning, as we go our ways, let us build our foundation on Jesus, amen. Let us build our relationships on Jesus, amen. Let us build our finances on Jesus, amen. Let us start with Him. Let Him be our anchor and let us just begin with Him in anything we can do, wherever we go, amen. I've just spoken about Jesus is everywhere, amen. So in every aspect of our life, He should be our foundation, amen. There's not a place in our life that we should leave Him out, amen. Amen. So this morning, I pray that we may not be tossed around by the waves. We may not drift away by anything that may come our way, but may our faith stand strong in the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So this morning I pray that we become like trees that are planted in God's word and our faith does not wither. Amen.
Amen.
With the season that comes, whatever season it may come in our lives, I just pray that we may be planted and rooted because the tree is solid. Amen. And whatever season may come, whether it's autumn, winter, whatever it is in our lives, I pray that our faith is symbolizing the leaves on the tree. It may not wither, amen?
Amen.
So this morning I pray that we've all received something and I pray that we can look forward to our journey, amen, with the Lord, amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Let us just bow our heads. Amen. Father, this morning we pray, Almighty God, may we begin our day with You, O God. May we begin our lives with You. May we begin our relationships with You, Almighty God. Lord God, may You anchor us, O Father God, in Your word, in Your hope, in faith, Almighty God. Father God, let us return, O Father God, to You, O God. Father God, if our faith, O God, has died down, Almighty God, or we've stopped believing today, Almighty God. Father God, may You restore our faith, O Father God. May we believe in You, Almighty God, more than ever before, Almighty God. Father God, we want more of You, Almighty God. Let our trust, O God, let our hope, Almighty God, let it be in You, Jesus, O Father God, and nothing else, Almighty God. May our hearts come to understand that we cannot rely on men, Almighty God. We cannot rely on wealth, O Father God. We cannot rely on anything that is of this world, Almighty God. But, O Father God, we can rely on You, Almighty God. You are an unchangeable God. You are an unshakable God, Almighty God. And we thank you, O God, for being that to us, Almighty God. Lord God, we just thank you, Almighty God, for your promises, Almighty God, that never change, Almighty God. You said you have plans for us, Almighty God, and they're good plans, O Father God. And this morning, O God, we believe, O Father God. And we thank you, Almighty God. We pray this, Almighty God, in your never failing name. Amen.
Amen.
You give life. You are love. You bring life to the darkness. You give hope. You restore. Every heart that is broken.